Inclusive, a Microsoft design toolkit. Antoine Hunter, deaf advocate, dance teacher, choreographer. I am a Nia Opus e Obidi Hene, father and dance advocate healer.
I got one time I had a really wonderful job offer, and I had to go to rehearsal practice. The only issue was the door.
Antoine, a tall, lean man with a beard, approaches an office building door and pushes numbers on an intercom keypad. In an interview, he signs.
I don't know what to say. I can't hear them.
Antoine presses his hand over the intercom speaker.
So I talked about the problem. They wouldn't hire me because it felt like it was too much energy just to have someone to let me in. Oh, that was a big function. That was a cool job I wanted. Wow. And that was that's the bell sometimes.
Using a smartphone, Antoine and a friend signed to each other.
I feel like as a kid, we step each other so easy, and that we are taught not to step each other. We're taught that we're so different, like in a bad way, you know. That we're taught that being deaf is a problem. It's not a problem. It's a different culture.
Antoine returns to his high school.
At Skyline High School, Miss Chang, my dance teacher, she said, everyone needs to create a piece, a group dance. I'm outcast. No one really want to work with me. I'll do a solo. Okay, do a solo. So I was trying to come up with an idea. I did a solo choreography with Whitney Houston, I Will Always Love You. I was dancing, I was nervous, dancing. And then, you know, in the middle of that song, that's the instrumental break. And I didn't have to worry about the words. And it was just moving, and something electric just came to my body. It was moving, you know what I mean? The pain, the suffering, the getting through the things that I was trying to make it from day to day. And then the music finished, it was like, and people stopped to look at me. And then it was like, oh yeah, it was so cool. And then my teacher was like, what do you think of that dance? What did you feel? And people were saying, oh, I felt like it was cold. I felt like it was trapped. It was suffering. And it was like, they were saying all the words that I was thinking and feeling. Yeah, that's exactly what I felt. That was communication. I fell in love right there.
Antoine applauds by lifting both hands and shaking them.
With music, I use a lot of bars that move for volume.
On stage with musicians, Antoine strikes a graceful pose.
I just want to see it.
He touches the instruments.
I see Marcus Shelby, he's like...
He mimes playing a cello.
And then I see the piano guy going...
He sways.
And my body records it. I memorize it really well.
Antoine starts to move.
I just start putting it all together, creating my own instrument, so I can dance with everyone.
Shirtless, Antoine shows his muscular arms and torso as he reaches, dances, turns, and kicks in rhythm.
Even though I really want to know, what's that music they're doing? I'm fine, I'm satisfied because I made mine. I have my voice, I have my music, and I'm with them. And it only happened without my hearing aid. I was able to listen to myself more. Wow, I started hearing my body.
In a class, Antoine's teenage students move in slow motion, stretching their bodies.
Been alone for a long time, and I really don't want people to be alone. That feeling is awful, really.
Antoine teaches a class to teenage girls. The students copy his movements.
And so I'm always trying to bring people together.
The dancers do slow hip rolls. They stretch their arms and gently wiggle their fingers, then strike poses in a group. As class ends, everyone claps. Antoine signs thank you and bows to his students. On a playground, a woman gives Antoine a hug. Later, he signs to a young mother as her toddler sits in a stroller.
I would say tell people to take a minute to listen to yourself. Keep going, go for it, keep fighting, and then you'll discover something that will be awakened and blow up. And you'll be like, what is that? What was that? That's your voice, that's your music, that's your spirit.
Antoine steps into an empty theater with rows of red seats. On stage, he stands in front of a white screen, undulating his arms. His long dreadlocks fly as he spins around.
My biggest dream is hopefully one big opera theater and international dancers to come in and we learning from them. And we're giving role models to the kids, you know, give one to my daughter. And keep on inspiring each other, keep bringing each other up.
A spotlight casts Antoine's shadow onto the white screen. With a serene smile, he takes a bow. Titles. This is part of a film series created to build empathy and inspire designers. Inclusive, a Microsoft Design Toolkit, a slanted light production, Microsoft.